And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to day five here at the WMF World Cup 23. Live, of course, from Ras Al Khaimah, the United Arab Emirates. Sorry that you missed me this morning, but I am back now for the remaining games of day five. I'm, of course, Louis Denham here, the commentator at the WMF World Cup. Just take a look at the fixtures from yesterday, a day full of goals and excitement, especially with that opening game going all the way to 5-5 to Kuwait versus Iraq. Montenegro walked through Oman with a 10-1 victory, but that final game, England proving against all odds, playing with one man down, they end up beating Slovakia 3-2 with a last minute goal. Today's fixtures, though, started with Mexico having the highest scoreline so far this tournament, with beating Guatemala 19-1. Ghana then followed by beating India comfortably 8-1. But up next, we do have a Group E match, B match, between Georgia and Ireland. And here is the Group B that Ireland and Georgia are competing in. Mexico, of course, topping that group with an incredible goal difference there, scoring 26 goals. Georgia also have 6 points. Ireland just have 3, but they could potentially walk away with 6 after this game. And Georgia take on Ireland, ladies and gentlemen. Be ready for a belter here. Both teams really looking to get 3 points and hopefully progress to the knockout stages. And like I said, ladies and gentlemen, we have another jam-packed day. We're going to be playing games all the way up until 10:15, which will be the last kickoff. So don't go anywhere. The WMF World Cup 23 here in Ras Al Khaimah will have you entertained. Teams.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national anthem of Ireland. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the national anthem of Georgia.
Oh, There you go, ladies and gentlemen, and the game is about to start. Put your hands together, let's welcome one more time the teams, Georgia versus Ireland.
And yes, we are back, the third game of day five here between Georgia and Ireland. Georgia will be playing in the white jersey, whereas Ireland typically will be playing in their infamous green. It's of course the fifth day of this incredible tournament, and my oh my, WMF World Cup here in Václav Kema has not disappointed. Let's take a look at the officials that will be looking after today's game between Georgia and Ireland. First official today is Cezar Ionuscu coming in from Romania. The second is Michael Beres from Slovakia. Then we got Graham Florence from the US of A. And we do have VAR, and that'll be headed by Marko Popovic from Montenegro. Captains there just swapping flags, showing true sportsmanship throughout the tournament. Just taking a quick look at the lineup, starting off with Ireland. Of course, coach Emir Mustic is really hoping to continue that form that they found against Guatemala in their last game, giving them 3 points. But if they want a chance to progressing out of the group, they'll have to win today. They will be captained by number 11, John Rogers. Georgia so far being extremely strong so far at the WMF World Cup 23, having 3 points in their opening fixture against Guatemala and continuing that form by beating champions Mexico. They're sitting comfortably on 6 points, and this will make them top the group if they walk away with another three. Georgian fans making themselves present here in Václav Kema. Strategically sat in the shade there. It's another warm day here in Václav Kema, which is the reason why we take that little bit of a break from the first two games all the way through to the other six. Ireland will be taking the kickoff here, and they get things underway. Here comes Gorman, playing it out on the right-hand side. Well controlled there from Georgia. It's gonna be a foul in the center of the park there from Tevzadze. Picks it up there nicely, flicks it on, and just gets cut off there from the Irish midfielder. Paul King getting away with not receiving any card there. Captain of Georgia today is number 5. Here on the ball, Nikolos. He has a shot there, well blocked from Ireland. Here's the Georgian manager hoping to get 3 wins out of 3 if they beat Ireland today. Definitely helping them progress through to the knockout stages. Well blocked there from Allwright. Nikolov passing it nice and horizontal here, Georgia. Shot on target, gets blocked. It's gonna be a Georgian throw. Here's the Irish manager, and only 3 points to the Irish team so far. If they have any chance, they're gonna have to score a lot of goals and win this game.
Come on,
And he cuts on the inside there. It's going to be a corner again to Georgia. There's the captain of Ireland, John Rogers. And he cuts it back. Well saved from Brian McCormack. Brian strategically wearing a cap there, just with the sun beaming down on us today here in Ras Al Khaimah. Nikolaos with the corner here for Georgia. Missed kick there. Runs all the way back to their goalkeeper, Nikolaos. Bringing it up nicely. Really dominating possession here, Georgia. Playing to the side here, side by side. Little warm-up session here. Looking to play it forward. Flicks it over. Potentially could have hit that first time. An Ireland panic at the back there. It's going to be a Georgian corner. Robert Allwright there, not really knowing where to go with it. And they cross it in. Kind of clashes with his forehead, the Georgian striker. Nikolaos plays it out wide. And it is a hot day again today, feeling like 39 degrees, but currently sat at 34. Back to Nikolaos, and he gets aside another corner there. Back here, number 11 on the ball. Goes for a cross goal shot, a long shot here from Ireland. A bit wasteful there from King. Georgie on the ball. Trying to find him again. Here he is. That's 1-0. What a goal that was. Just look at this passage of play from Georgia. Beautiful finish. Ireland split open there way too easily. Right through the middle and lays him off. Georgie just slots it home. Right past Brian McCormack with ease. Ireland come again, all right on the ball. They need to have a bit of a spell of possession, you could say. King looks forward. Rogers mis-headering that, unfortunately. Close feet here from Georgia. And they win themselves a corner. Pass all the way back. Bit of a theme of their corners so far. Definitely worked on in the training ground. Here comes McCormack. On to Paul King. Looking dead center here. John Rogers, can he take it down? Georgia really dominating possession here early on. Taguchi on the ball. Cuts on the inside here. Is he gonna have a strike? Goes for the run instead. It's out for an Irish throw. goes long. Another throw to Ireland. Taguchi picks it up quite easily there. Well blocked though. John Rogers gives off his teammate. Too much on there. Well played from Paul King. Here he is again, going long, trying to find Rogers. Just curling the wrong way there. It's going to be a goal kick to Georgia. Nikolaos plays it to his teammate. Got some spectators out, especially regarding Georgian fans, really giving them the seventh player that they need to get 3 points here. He moves it up. Just much more nifty than Ireland so far, Georgia. Good turn there though. Gorman. Plays it back to McCormack. High pressure here from Georgia. And they let it go. It's gonna be brought back here. Free kick. Yellow card awarded as well. Number six for Ireland there, Tiernan Kilnoyn getting the yellow card. Even though it looked like he came off worse. Georgia have a free kick here in a promising position. A lot of players behind it though. Go for it. Oh, that is unlucky from an Irish perspective. McCormack in goal for Ireland. Completely dumbfounded by the deflection. Not a lot he could have done there. Steps to the right, steps to the left, and it goes to his right. Here come Georgia again. Played all the way through there. Oh, look at that. Confidence from the young man there. Gaz Deliani really showing his skills in Georgian colours. Ireland do win themselves a free kick here in their own half. Ireland not really having an attempt or a proper attempt on goal. Take it down nicely. Gorman. Lovely skill there from the Irishman. Just couldn't get that final touch on it. Good clearance from Nikolaos. He goes to the chip in. Really helping the Georgian winger here. Ireland not doing themselves any favours. And that's 3-0. Gogashvili there. Picking it up in his own half, assisted by the Irishman, slides it to his left, gets in center and puts it away. And that is 3-0 to Georgia. This is really gonna, if they get all 3 points, put them top of Group B, guaranteeing them into the group stages or the knockout stages. Georgi on the ball. Oh, bit sloppy again from Ireland. They do not want to be losing possession there. Over there from the man at number 23, Becker, Taguchi. Really, Ireland under a lot of pressure here in the first half. Goes out again there. Goal kick to McCormack. Unlucky from Taguchi. And he goes down there. Grant winning his country, his team a foul in their own half. McCormack on the ball for Ireland. No real options there. They give it back to Georgia. Well intercepted though. Grant on the ball. Goes for goal. Ryan Nicholas. Georgia looking to split the lines here. Nicholas on the ball, could not get that ball back to Nicholas. Georgi plays it back to Nicholas. This is the movement off the ball from Georgia. Oh, they got away with that again there. Should have been four. Just could not put that on target. It's back to McCormack here for Ireland. Medine on the ball. Cannot find his man. Ireland can't make any passes. What a goal that was. Blimey. Georgi with a beautiful finish, putting Georgia 4-0 up here. And Ireland don't know what to do. McCormack just didn't get down quick enough. And it's slotted in that bottom left-hand corner. All right.
No way, Bob, no way.
Here we go again. Nicholas. Oh, caught by McCormack though. Nicholas. In here, all right. It's the best opportunity Ireland have had. Well played from Grant there at the back, helping his team out. Great ball this from King. All right, decides to go with his right foot there. Straight at Nicholas.
Can he keep it in? He has done. Look at that confidence. It has gone up though. It'll be a corner to Ireland. Nothing coming of it though. And here come Georgia, throwing in from the left-hand side. Back to Nikolaos. Can they get a goal here, Ireland? Open net. Totally back in goal though. Bob Allwright. Onto Grant. Grant finding Paul King. Trying a bit too much there, Ireland. That's definitely gone out of play. It's going to be an Irish throw here. Dorman back on the pitch for his country. Oh, beautiful control there from McCormack. Georgia are through here, and they played it on. Nikolaos makes it 5-0 Georgia. Not just captaining his country tonight, he's scoring for them too, and basically securing them all 9 points out of a possible 9, putting them through to the group or the knockout stages. Playing it wide here. Plays it long. Dorman just can't get onto that. Georgia just being well contained here by Ireland. Nikolaos plays that out wide. Mikhail on the ball. Oh, wow. Oh my gosh. Didn't even know that was a possibility. What a finish there from Mikhail. Lovely through ball, found in acres of space. McCormack is not going to be happy with that, beaten at his near post. Grant leaves it, it runs all the way through. Gorman for Ireland. Going to be a throw in to Ireland though. 6-0 with 4 minutes left to play in the first half. Oh, he skies it. Comes all the way to the stands there. And here they come again. Playing it wide, Mikhail just after scoring that beautiful goal there. McCormack plays it to Gorman. Back from John Rogers. Goes all the way to John though. Can't take it down well enough. Grant doing his best out there. Taguchi on the ball. Here's Nicholas. No real pressure from Ireland. And no real rush from Georgia. Serving their energy here. Here he is again, Taguchi. Pekka Taguchi trying to find his man. It's 3-on-2 here. Ireland could do something. Cuts on the inside. Gorman again. It's going to be a foul to Ireland, and rightfully so. Gorman beat his man, but got clipped on the way. Gorman's actually going to take this one. It's a big opportunity, this, for Ireland. He's got that right-hand corner in his sights. Goes low and off of the Georgian defender. Georgia's throw in here. Cleared out by the goalie McCormick there. Feeling the pressure, Ireland, so far this half. And not dealing with it that well. Brandt tries to read that drop shoulder. Georgia win it back quickly. Georgi on the ball, passes it back to Nicholas. Just 30 seconds of regular time, and here comes Nicholas. Georgia have a throw. But yes, just 20 seconds now of regular time, and I'm hearing that no added minutes on this first half. Here comes Grant. Lovely play from Grant. King plays it to Gorman. Oh, put it away. Nicholas, a brick wall in the goal there. Oh. And that's it for halftime there. 6-0 from Georgia. Ireland huffing, puffing, and unfortunately not being able to control Georgian's attack. We're going into halftime here with Georgia really dominating this half, 6-0. Taking a quick look at the match statistics from the first half between Georgia and Ireland. Georgia really dominating in both shots and shots on target. 8 of their 11 hitting the target there. 4 out of 6 for Ireland hitting the goal. Georgia also dominated in corners with 5-2. Not that many fouls in this game. They're keeping it nice and clean. However, one yellow card for Ireland. We'll be right back after a quick 5-minute break for the second half of Georgia versus Ireland. Baby, And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, for the second half of Georgia versus Ireland. Georgia probably going to be taking this half nice and comfortably, nice and slow. After being 6 goals ahead already in the first half, Georgia playing in white and Ireland playing in green. Goal now for Georgia. We do have a substitution. It's Bakur Sajali. And here he is again, Bakur. On the ball, Nikolaos, the captain of Georgia. He plays it wide now. Back to the goalie. Just comfortably keeping possession here. And here he goes for it. Backer. Not a bad effort. Georgia now looking up the left flank. Constant attack really from Georgia. And he goes for it. Unlucky effort there. Nikolaos just not being able to put that on target. McCormack now in the shade for Ireland. Is that going to help him? I don't know. Nikolaos, the captain of Georgia, taking his time with his throw down to Bakur. Lays it out wide. Mikhail, who scored a beautiful goal, near post finish in the first half. Georgia, unlucky effort there. Finds Paul King. Ireland just not being able to deal with the pressure that well. Here come Georgia. It's going to be a throw in though.
Just got to be quicker, lads. That's got
to
be quicker.
A corner, I confirm. A corner to Georgia. And Paul King on the ball. Bringing it forward with ease here. Cut off, though, nicely. Back to McCormack. And King picks it up again. 1-2 with Gorman. Plays it, unfortunately for him, intercepted too easily from Georgia. And they have it again. Trying to go around the goalie. Mikhail. Mikhail going alone, not the right option.
Go, lads, quicker!
Nice there from Ireland. Can they get a goal here? Could not finish that, Andrew Hodner. But they're going again. It's a better start this second half than what we saw in the entire first half. Mikhail on the ball, passes it to Bakker. They play out wide. No one on the inside. Ireland might be on a break here. Grant goes for goal. Possibly selfishly there from Grant. Good challenge. And Ireland move it up again. Here he comes. Hodner. Easily caught from Bakker. And the drop ball for Georgia gives them possession back, but the high press from Ireland keeps them in their own half. Levani back to Bakur. Well away though from Ireland. Can he play his man through? He can. Hodnett. Oh! Dangerous challenge there from Bakker. It's a yellow card to Bakker. Number 12 for Georgia. Can Ireland get on the score sheet here with a free kick in the opposition's half? The Georgian fans hoping for either a save or block here. Grant lays it off. Oh, good effort there from Bob Allwright. Just not on target. Just wide. And they cut in again. Taguchi on the ball. Definitely looking for a through ball rather than a shot there. Georgia having a nice position. Taguchi! What a save that was from Brian McCormack. Looking for the pass forward there, Nagzari. Cormack picks it up nicely. He got the ball again. Long side of the post. Here come Ireland. Misplaced pass there, sloppily. It's going to be Georgian ball here on the left-hand side. Gorman back on the pitch for Ireland. Plays it to his striker. He Georgi dealing with it safely, playing it back to Bakker. And he's on the ball, getting a lot of room there. Highland just holding off, fighting the attack there from Georgia. Gorman in defence for Ireland. Unfortunately, that just crept out of play there. Going to be a Georgian ball. Backer in goal for Georgia today, in the second half at least. Making the strike, plays out on the right. Got the ball here. Ooh, sloppy. Now the sun has gone behind a cloud. It's getting nice and cool this evening here in Ras Al Khaimah. McCormack on the ball. Here's Gorman. Can he get Ireland on the score sheet? He does. Well played to Ireland. Just takes it round easily. Backer is not going to be happy with that in net for Georgia. Beaten way too easily at his near post. But that puts Ireland on the score sheet, and it's 6-1 now to Georgia. Taguchi, just 13 minutes left of regular time here, folks. Becca Taguchi. They're going to split the lines here, just taking his time with it. Remember, if Georgia win this game, they top the group with 9 points. And I believe that Mexico would be second in the group, knocking Ireland out. Ooh, unlucky with a cross. Gorman. Right to McCormack. It's going to be a throw into Ireland. No, a free kick. Well defended there. Nixari trying to beat his man. He does so. That's quite fortunate with a few defections. Back to Backer. Georgi Gazdeliani laying off to Backer. And he's going to go for goal. Oh my days. That was a rocket. Lucky there, the Georgian goalie, not to put that in the corner. Gorman. Irish ball here. King. Long ball here. Can he find his man? He can. Big opportunity that for Hanlon. Could not take it down. Gorman picks it up lovely. Some close touches there for Gorman. Keeping Ireland possession. This is more like it from Ireland. Here's Paul King.
Much better, boys, much better.
Well picked up though from Georgia. Lovely through ball. McCormack with a beautiful clearance and read of that through ball. Here comes Georgia. Is it wide?
Brilliant, McGeady, brilliant.
Wait, don't go.
Georgia have an opening. Skies it over the bar. He would have expected to do better there, Gyorgy. The weather has started to cool down a touch, as it's cloudy out here in Arsenal Kemba. Sitting at 34 degrees, it feels like 39. We are well shaded right now by a quite massive cloud in the sky. Ireland need to calm down here. Play up to Gorman. And here he is.
There he is.
The only goal scorer for Ireland tonight.
All right, good idea.
Evans, come back.
Moving up with some urgency here, Georgia. Surprising considering the scoreline.
Well done, Bob. Much better ball. Well done, lad. Good tracking.
They do say the best form of defence is offence. And here they go again. Georgia passing it, unfortunately cannot. Oh, he's given a penalty there. The ref has awarded a penalty, I believe, against Paul King. It's been awarded and it's been VAR checked here. And it's a goal. Beautifully slot home from Georgia, making it 7-1. Gyorgy Gazdeliani with that finish. Being awarded a free kick here in a lovely position. Looks like Grant is going to want to bend this. He's going for it. Unfortunately, not the contact that he was hoping for. Can Georgia make it 8? Oh, wow. And you've got to take your hats off there. Gyorgy Apsiari there with a beautiful goal for Georgia. And they do make it 8. To Ireland's 1. It's a man down here in the center of the pitch. The goal scorer, Gyorgy. Looks like cramp. His teammates are helping him off the pitch here. think El Guja is going to be subbed on for him, number two for Georgia.
Go left, here's boys, Ireland.
He's just cramped up there, unfortunately. Should be okay, though. 5 minutes left of regular time in this fixture between Georgia and Ireland. Lovely pass to Grant. Cuts in. Oh, puts it wide with his weak foot there. Garvin Grant not happy with that one. Just can't curl it enough there. It's going to be a goal kick. Oh. Cormack equal to that strike from the opposition goalie. And again, McCormack. Oh. Ireland just waiting for that final whistle as Nicolas Cotan-Nadz just puts Georgia 9-1 ahead here. Slots it between the goalie's legs. Throw in now to Georgia up top. Here they come. Mikhail plays it back to Bakker. 3 minutes left of regular time. That clearance is still in play. So is the header. Well cut out by Ireland. Oh, McCormack with a beautiful right arm, pushing it onto the post. Well, the crossbar, I believe. Beautiful, beautiful save there. Backer with another strike from his own, being the goalkeeper, and what a save that was from McCormack. Here it goes again. He really wants to be on the score sheet tonight. McCormack. Georgia on the ball here, plays it to their goalkeeper, Bakker. Mikhail. Lovely cut inside there for Lavani. Cuts on the right. Oh, no. McCormack has had enough in goal for Ireland today. And that makes it double digits for Georgia. Lavani Savanitz scores the 10th for Georgia. Great left strike there. Cuts on his left and slots at home. Paul King starting it again for Ireland. Just over 30 seconds left. As I'm hearing, there's going to be no added time here, folks. Here they go. Whipped in. Backer. He's going to have a go here. Surely. No, plays smartly back to his teammate. Mikhail on the ball. And the ref blows the final whistle as Georgia walk through Ireland there, topping their group, getting all 9 points possible. Out of three games, Georgia walk away with 9 and Ireland walk away with 3 points. And as I believe, the final standings of that group unfortunately sends Ireland home. But that was a Group B match between Georgia and Ireland, with Georgia winning 10-1. Let's have a look at those highlights. Here are the stats for that game there. Georgia beating Ireland 10-1. We're having 26 shots to Ireland's 15, 16 of them being on target to Ireland's 10. Georgia also dominating in corners as well, both committing fouls and both just receiving one yellow card. We're going to take a 15-minute break before we come in for game 4 of day 5 here at the WMF World Cup 23. In Ras Al Khaimah, United Arab Emirates.
And we are back. An absolute great game between Ireland and Georgia. But for some reason, I don't know what happened with Ireland. They were doing great in the beginning, and then something happened. With that said, I'm going to meet up with one of the players. Let me ask him what happened within that match. Sir, first off, congratulations for being here and participating in this wonderful World Cup. It was so nice for us to see you. But what happened today in the game?
I think we just got caught a bit out with Georgia's quality. For a lot of us, for Ireland, we actually live here in the UAE, so we came together only a couple of days before the tournament. We played together in 11-a-side football, but this is a completely new game for us. So we played against Mexico, we got taught a bit of a lesson by the world champs. We done very well against Guatemala, and we started well against Georgia, but you know, these guys are a very, very good team. You know, they beat Mexico in the last game, we knew it was going to be difficult, and credit to them, they really played a great game. So unfortunately, we just weren't at the standard needed.
It's enough that you participated, you represented your country very well. We're happy that we have you, and we're looking forward to see you on the next one then, right?
Yeah, thank you very much, and thank you to the organisers. I think a lot of us, I say, live in Dubai, so it's a pleasure to be able to be here in Ras Al Khaimah in UAE. And it's an amazing tournament, so thank you to everyone.
Pleasure. Good luck. Thank you very much. So that was Ireland. Let's talk to the winning team for Georgia. How are you? How are you?
All good? Thanks. Yes, of course, all good.
Tell me, so earlier in your previous games, you guys were like building it up. Today, you were like rocking it to the next level. What did you guys do?
We had to do everything in the stadium to win these games. It was a pretty hard group. There was a defending world champion, Mexico. We had a very, very hard game against them. We did everything in the stadium. And so we won three games from three, and we are happy now. But it's past already, and we are looking forward to the playoffs.
Well, we are looking forward right now to see you on the champion list.
Yes, of course. Yes, of course. We came here to win every game here.
Well, good luck to you and congratulations. Now that you are qualified, I think you need to celebrate.
Yes, of course. Yes, of course. Today we celebrate and tomorrow we will begin training for the 1-8 finals.
Congratulations once again. Well done. Well done, Giorgio. Well done. There you go. That was it. So, more games to come. If you're still watching us and you're not here, you're missing it. So, I'll be waiting for you right here in Ras Al Khaimah. Take care.